What's up, y'all? It's Demogenine. It's time for another one. So, before we get started, I want to give a big shout out to my brother, Mark with a C, aka The Gospel, because I want to piggyback off of something he talked about earlier this week in regards to recasting T'Challa, right? And he brought up a story about Nichelle Nichols wanting to leave the role of Lieutenant O'Hara in Star Trek, and Dr. Martin Luther King persuaded her to, you know, change her mind, right? So, let's take a look at this real quick, and I'm not going to go over this part of it yet, but I just want to give people a snapshot of what I'm talking about. So, this is here from Screen Rant, and it says, Star Trek, how Martin Luther King Jr. saved O'Hara. So, I'm just going to skip right down here to this part that I highlighted. It says, Dr. Martin Luther King convinced Nichelle Nichols to stay on the Star Trek because he recognized the cultural significance of how the show was shaping the future and saw the character of O'Hara as a significant symbol of dignity. Now, what does this have to do with T'Challa? So, the one thing I want to point out is, you know, the whole push for diversity and inclusion now, as if we haven't had that happen before, which is mind-blowing to me how we have people out here who act like somebody like Nichelle Nichols, who is a trailblazer. See, when I hear this stuff about diversity and inclusion and all the stuff acting like it's something new that happened in 2016, it really pisses me off as somebody who's been in this geekdom sphere for a very long time. As somebody who enjoyed entertainment, period. I've seen diversity and inclusion when it mattered. You see, Nichelle Nichols is a trailblazer because it mattered when she was doing it because it hadn't been done before, which is why Martin Luther King Jr. said it was significant in her staying where she was at. So, with that part out of the way, what does that have to do with T'Challa? So, you have a significant character, you know, being that he was the first Marvel's first black superhero. And you know, we fast forward to now when Marvel is a big deal to have, because we've had Marvel movies before, but they never really was on this epic scale as the MCU. And that's not to discount the Blades and the Spawn, even though Spawn was not Marvel. But you know what I'm saying. But as far as black superheroes, this is like the first one in MCU with that level of hype behind it. So for you to go ahead and say, you know what? Chadwick Boseman passed away, so we're going to kill off the character. And give you T'Challa Jr., which is not King T'Challa. He would be Prince T'Challa, not King T'Challa, right? Which I don't even think that's a thing in the comics. I think that's a solely MCU thing. I haven't really been following Marvel like that in a very long time, but I don't recall it being a Prince T'Challa. But what does that mean, right? So, again, when Heath Ledger passed away, they didn't say, hey, we're getting rid of all the Jokers. When Christopher Reeve passed away, we didn't say we're getting rid of all of the Superman, right? But for whatever reason, when you have an iconic character like Black Panther and the actor dies, we want to get rid of him. Does that make sense to anybody? Like, can anybody make that make sense? I mean, seriously, can they? But the thing that really gets me is when you talk about the cultural significance and the relevance behind that character. Think about this. You can go back and you can recount all of the Superman, the Batman, the Flashes even, you know what I'm saying, that we've had over the years, but we've only had one Black Panther. One Black Panther. In live action, that is, you know. Obviously, we've had more iterations of it, comics and cartoons and all that stuff like that. That's besides the point. But as far as live actions, you can go back and you can recount these. Now, in the case of the entertainment industry as it is, they refuse to give black people an original character, i.e. something from actual Africa, where instead of, you know, palette swapping, you know, white characters, a black character. But when you have a black character that is its own thing, its original thing, you say, oh, we're going to kill him off. Does that make sense to anybody? Like, I don't understand how that works, how that flowed, how that line of thinking went through the executives over at Marvel and Disney. But again, like I said, they refuse to give us a actual, you know, a folklore, a story, anything like that. That if you want to say you want to do actual diversity and inclusion, either give us a you know, something recently made that's brand new, or why don't you, I don't know, bring something out from, you know, like I said, African folklore and stuff like that. You could do that. You could do that. But being that you are bound and determined not to do that, and then when we have a character like a T'Challa Black Panther, and then you say, oh, we're doing it now, but then when that actor dies, oh, we're getting rid of him. I don't get it. I don't get it. So, at the end of the day, they should have recasted the character, because, I mean, we've had characters recast. I mean, think about this. Think about this, how crazy this is. We are going to have a new Hulk movie, or not Hulk, but Thunderbolts, I guess. And, of course, I believe William Hurt was the character, the actor name who passed away, who played Thunderbolt Ross. He passed away, so they're going to have Harrison Ford play him now. You see where I'm getting at, right? I mean, you recasted Rhodey. Nobody's... and they didn't even pick an actor who looked like him. They got a totally different character, actor, to play... Terrence Howard, I'm about to say Lawrence Fishburne. Terrence Howard played in Iron Man. You got a totally different person to play Rhodey. And you did that in... And we have something that makes sense. Okay, the man passed away. We will understand. I totally would understand if you recasted somebody. And then you don't do it. But that's neither here nor there. But anyway, how do you guys feel about the situation of the relevancy of Black Panther, and how the people who did it before us, how, like, Martin Luther King said to O'Hara, how that will make sense for cultural reference then when it actually mattered, and even now it still matters, and then you just don't want to do it. But let me know how you feel about that. Like, subscribe. If you want to support the channel, you get that super thanks. And remember, you can't be good, be good at it. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly.